Hey guys, it's Paula. It is the end of January 2019. We made it through our first month of the new year, so good job everyone. I am doing a favorites video today, and I want to make it a goal to do a favorites video at the end of every month this year. Sometimes I'm successful when I set a goal like that, and sometimes I'm not, but you know what? 2019 is going to be successful. So I have compiled a list of things that I want to share with you that I have been loving in January, and without further ado, we're just gonna hop into things. Okay, I have a decent amount of actual beauty and like hair favorites to talk about, which usually doesn't happen, but as I said way too much in my last video, I have been watching so much Kathleen Lights, and she is just so inspirational to me in the makeup world. Anytime she buys new makeup, I also want to buy that makeup. So after watching a lot of her videos, I made a list of some of her favorites and just things that she's mentioned, and I decided to take a trip to Ulta and buy some of those things. My first favorite of January is actually a foundation, which is crazy for me. If you know anything about me, you know that I have been using the CoverGirl Outlast Stay Fabulous foundation since I was like 16. It's been the only foundation I've ever successfully bought and liked and kept repurchasing. But I have been seeing a lot of videos and like wear tests on this guy. This is the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define foundation. It was getting a lot of positive reviews, so I figured, you know what? I should just try something new. New year, new foundation, right? And I really enjoy it. I got the lightest shade, which may be too light for me, but also it's the middle of winter, so I feel like it's a pretty good match today. My last video was Ghost Central. I'm not sure what the lighting was doing, but today I feel like it's a pretty good match. I think what I like most about this foundation is the packaging, mainly because it's so easy to use. It has this giant doe foot applicator, so it is so fun and convenient to just paint it on your face, and then I take my sponge and I dab it in, and it's just perfect. The coverage is amazing. It does say full coverage foundation, and it is absolutely full coverage. I'm just so happy with it. There's times when, I don't know, especially on my nose, it's just hard to get foundation to look good on my nose or like around my nose, so it kind of skips. But I try to put concealer on top of it too to just really get everything in there. So that's the one thing that this doesn't do very well, but if I'm thinking about it, no foundation looks perfect on my skin because I don't have perfect skin, but this definitely makes me full coverage and as flawless as I can be, and I love it. I want to say it was $10 or $11 or $12 at Ulta. I'll have everything linked down below, but if you are in a foundation rut like me and it's hard to find full coverage foundations that work for you, give this guy a go. I am so happy with it. Next thing I purchased on recommendation from basically every single beauty YouTuber is the Morphe setting spray. It's called the Continuous Setting Mist, but it's absolutely magical. I never even used setting sprays before this. Honestly, I was like, what's the point? I don't want to add moisture to my face. I want to be as matte as possible. Now I'm realizing being super matte just makes you look dry, makes you look cakey. So it's nice to have a little setting spray to really just blend everything together. It's crazy when you just look at your face makeup, especially like my bronzer and everything, and it just helps it sink into my skin and make this beautiful canvas on my face. And if you guys don't know, the Morphe setting spray has the finest mist of any setting spray in the world. It is so nice. I don't need to put more on, but I'm going to. It just, oh, it feels so refreshing, just like a little pick-me-up. I love this thing. Also, not that expensive. I was expecting it to be like 20 bucks, but it's not. I forget how much it was, but you can go check it out for yourself. Then my last makeup product for today is actually a new lipstick. It's from Almay, actually, and I don't have any makeup from Almay. I feel like, I don't know, they usually don't have good stuff, or at least groundbreaking stuff. But these are their new, actually, I don't know what it's called. It has hashtag lip vibes on it, so maybe it's the new lip vibes lipsticks. And this is so gorgeous. If you look at this packaging, they have so many shades and they all have this super cool packaging. Mine has cheetahs and flowers on it. I got a matte one. It is in the color Go Wild, and it's absolutely perfect. It is my favorite color to wear. It goes with any makeup look, any outfit. It's actually really similar to what I'm wearing now. This is an Anastasia liquid lipstick, so it's not this, but they're pretty much the same color. And when I use this, I have been loving this Sephora lip liner as well. I feel like I got this in my Sephora play, but it's honestly just their Sephora Rouge Gel Lip Liner. And it is absolutely perfect. It's a little retractable one, and these colors go so well together. So I line my lips, fill them in, and then put this matte lipstick on top, and it is so pretty. I love these together. It's incredible. Next up, I actually have a curling wand to talk to you about. And the last time I bought a curling wand was definitely in high school. I bought my Remington clipless curling wand, the pink one that I talked about in every single video back in the day. But because of Kathleen Lights, she showed a curly hair tutorial, and she has naturally curly hair already, so she was just kind of like sprucing it up. But I saw the wand that she was using, and I just wanted to try it and see if I could get super curly hair like her. So this is it. It is the Her Styler Baby Curl Purple. I think it comes in pink and purple. I got the purple one, obviously. It is a 9/18 millimeter barrel. So there you go. This was $20 on Amazon, I think, which is a pretty good deal for a heat tool. If you watched my Trends That Need to Die video, I used this on my hair to make it super curly, and everyone was asking how I did my hair. Can you do a tutorial on these curls? And I probably won't do a tutorial because, like, use this wand, get the hair, you know, is pretty self-explanatory, but this is what I used. It's definitely more time-consuming than what I'm used to. When I curl my hair with my other curling wand, it's just like really quick, 5 minutes, add some waves to my hair, you know? But this one, I actually have to like pull out the pieces, stand there, wrap it up, and it gives you these tight little curls. So the first day I do this, it's kind of like, whoa, that's some curly hair that's not used to being on my head. But I love the second or the third day that I use this because my curls fall out and it's just so beautiful and curly and wavy, and I feel like a princess. So if you are looking for a curling wand that will give you tight curls as opposed to just waves, this is the way to go. I really like this, a great deal for your money, and I'm very happy that Kathleen Lights talked about it. So hopefully I can pass on the message to you guys as well. All right, that is it for my physical favorites. Now, of course, I have some TV and music to talk about. I didn't watch like any movies this month, so sorry. But TV shows, absolutely. That is all I've been doing, especially now. Chicago is in the middle of a polar vortex where it's negative degrees every single day, so they're advising you to just not go outside. So I'm staying in a lot and watching TV. I finished two shows on Netflix this month. The first is Ozark, and I've been hearing a lot of people talk about it, mostly last year, and then I finally decided to watch it. There are two seasons of it currently on Netflix, and it's so good. It's not a show that I would normally watch. It's about this family that gets tied up in drugs and the cartel, and they move to the Ozarks to try to escape all of it. It's pretty dark, I'm not gonna lie, but I really enjoyed it. I can't watch too much of it at a time because I get kind of sad. it's just dark. It's a dark show about the drug trade, but I really liked it. My next show is sort of a comedy. It's Friends from College, and I watched the first season last year when it came out. I watched it in a day. And then I was like, oh, okay, this is fun. Where's the rest of the show? And then they finally came out with season two this year. It's about these six friends from college, and then Billy Eichner is like the one that one of them is marrying. And they all get together again like after some time, and they basically all hook up with each other and like cause a lot of drama. But it's funny, it's dramatic, but it's funny. And the episodes are only like 20 or 30 minutes each, so it's super easy to just blow through it in a day if you just want like a really easy thing to watch. Now let's move on to some music. As you guys know, I'm a big fan of making Spotify playlists, and normally each new season I get sick of my old playlist, so I want to make another. So I've made a new playlist for this year. I will link it down below as I usually do. So most of the songs on that playlist have been my favorites because that's all I'm listening to, but I'm going to mention a few. First of all, just real quick, real quick, let me mention Seven Rings by Ariana Grande. I don't care if she maybe stole the melody or stole the lyrics from someone else. I mean, I listened to those other songs that were trying to challenge her, and they're kind of similar, but not really. So I think people just need to calm down. I've been supporting our girl Ari since forever, since she was on Victorious. She's my favorite human ever. So I am so excited for all of her new releases, and her new album is coming out next week. I can't believe it. We are so blessed, but I really like Seven Rings. I have yet to hear it like out in public in a club, but I really want to. We're going like dancing this weekend, and I really hope it comes on because it is just that kind of jam that you need to hear to get you pumped up and dancing and having a good time. Then my other music favorite that I want to mention, I don't know how to say it. It is these two guys called Gianni and Kyle, or Yanni. I mean, if he was Greek, I would call him Yanni, but it's Gianni. They are super underrated, but I want more people to listen to them. They give me such Black Bear vibes. Sometimes their songs come on and I think I'm listening to a new Black Bear song, but it's not, it's these guys. But they released an album called She's No Angel, and I love every single song on it. It is just such a groovy, like really like Black Bear if you're into that. It's sort of like hip hop influenced, R&B, pop. I just really like their stuff. My favorite song is Do You Even Miss Me At All. The beat is there, the lyrics are like pow, like I just wanna sing that to someone that I'm mad at, you know? And then my other two favorite songs are You and Me and Hennessy and Five Shots. Go listen to them. Honestly, they need more love. I think they're going on tour with Hoodie Allen, so hopefully they'll get some more exposure, but I really like their stuff and you should go listen to them. And those are all of my January favorites for this year. Hopefully my earrings haven't been too distracting. I feel them like racking around my face and it's a little much. But that is all for me today. I hope you guys liked this video. Give it a thumbs up if you did and comment down below what have you been loving in January. Give me some new stuff to check out. That's it. Okay, I'm gonna go and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!